Hey, it's Rena, and today I'm going to be doing a beginner's guide to how to get started with GoodNotes app. If you're new to my channel, I do GoodNotes plan with me's tips and tutorials, so make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell for more of this content. So here is GoodNotes 5 app in the App Store. This is my favorite app on the iPad for note-taking and digital planning, and I use this app almost every day. This app used to be $7.99, but it is now free to download and try, so I thought this would be a good time to make a beginner's tutorial, and I'm just going to be covering the basics, so I'm not going to be going through all of the features. I do have other GoodNotes tutorials on my channel, I'll link them in the description down below if you're looking for more advanced tips, tricks, and hidden features. So let's get straight into the tutorial, and if you need this slowed down or sped up, you can use the YouTube video settings to do so. So here I am in the GoodNotes dashboard. This is what you're going to see when you first go into the app. So the first thing I'm going to show you is how you can create a notebook. So to create a notebook, you can tap on this new icon here. And then when you tap it, this drop-down menu is going to come up and you can tap on notebook. And here you can see you have different types of paper, blank, dotted, squared, ruled, and then you also have different layouts. And up here, if you tap in this drop down here, you also have different colored paper, white, dark, and yellow. And you also have different paper sizes, which is quite useful if you want to be printing your document. And here you have different orientations, so landscape and portrait. So once you've picked your paper, you can then pick your cover. So if you just tap on this cover, you can see different cover options. Then you can scroll down and see more of them. And I'm just going to choose that one here. And then you can tap in this title part and give your notebook a title. And then tap on create. And you can see this has opened up your notebook. Next, I'm going to show you how to import a PDF document. So once again, tap on the new icon. And then this time tap on import. And you can just browse to where your file is. So here, these are the files on my iPad, and this is the file I want to import. So depending on how big your file is, this could take a couple of seconds. So just wait for that to finish. And here is the imported document, and you can swipe left and right to flip the pages. So this is my digital planner that I use in the app almost every day. It doesn't come with the app, but I'll leave the details for this planner in the description down below. Next, I'm going to talk about this icon here, which allows you to toggle between view and edit modes. So this is view mode, and the toolbar along the top is white. And in view mode, you can navigate through your file and use any of the hyperlinks. And if you tap on this icon again, this will take you into edit mode. So in edit mode, the hyperlinks will not work. But in edit mode, you have all of the toolbar along the top here. So in edit mode, you can write and you can add to your file, but you cannot use the hyperlinks. Whereas if you want to navigate your file, you need to put yourself back into view mode. And now, once again, you can use the hyperlinks. First, I'm going to talk about zooming in and out of the page. So you can just do that with your fingers and you can zoom in like this and you can zoom out. And you can also do that when you're in edit mode, you can zoom in and zoom out. Next, let's go back into edit mode and I'm going to talk you through each of these tools and what they do. So the first thing you need to know is how to use the pen tool. So if you tap this pen tool up here, you can see that you can write with the Apple Pencil. And if you tap this tool again, it brings up this panel here and you have different pen styles. So fountain pen is pressure sensitive. So you can see you have some options up here, and pressure sensitive means that the heavier you press down with the Apple Pencil, the wider the stroke. And then if you tap this again, let's try the ballpoint pen. So this has an even pressure. So no matter how hard or light you press, it's going to have the same width stroke. And then you have the brush pen here, which is once again pressure sensitive. And I would say this has more pressure sensitivity than the fountain pen. For beginners, I recommend sticking with the ball pen because of the even stroke. You don't have to worry about how hard you're pressing. And I just find that it's easiest to write neatly using this pen. If you want to change the color of your stroke, you can come up here and tap on one of these. So if you tap on it, you can see you might have some preset colors that you can choose. And if you come down here, you can tap on custom and choose more colors. And there's even a color wheel. So I'm just going to choose any of these. And then you can see this has changed the color of your stroke. And you have three different slots here, so you can just come in here and choose different ones. So you can easily toggle between these to get different colors. So this page is getting a bit full now, so I'm just going to take us to a different page where I can show you the different stroke widths. So up here, if you tap on these, you can see you have a pen thickness. So you can change the slider to change the width of your pen. So here you have a really thin one that you can barely see. And at the other end, you have this 2mm pen. Personally, I like to use a width of around 0.4, 0.5. I find that is a good width for handwriting. You can draw a straight line with the pen tool, and to do that, you just have to draw and hold. Next, I'm going to show you the eraser tool, and that's this one here. So you can tap on this and you can see you have three different sizes, and you can just choose one and you can erase what you have on the page. If you tap on the eraser icon again, this brings up this panel and you can see you have different eraser styles. So if I choose the precision eraser, you can see this erases only part of the stroke. Whereas if I go back in and I choose the stroke eraser, that is going to erase my entire stroke. At this point, I'm just going to show you how to use the undo and redo buttons because these are really useful. So you can see these arrows here at the top. If you tap on this back arrow, this is an undo. So you can undo your last action, and then tapping on this forward arrow, you can redo. If you have a lot of objects on the page and you just want to delete everything, you can also tap on the three dots up here and then tap on clear page, and this will just get rid of everything on the page. Next, I'm going to show you the highlighter tool up here. So tap on the highlighter tool and then you can highlight your handwriting. And if you hold it, it will also snap straight. To change the color of the stroke, once again, you can tap in the color icon, and here you can choose from the presets or you can choose the custom colors. And once again, you have three different color slots. To change the width of your highlighter, you can tap up here. So you've got these three different slots and you can adjust your highlighter thickness. Next, I'm going to jump back a bit and show you how to use the selective eraser tool. So if you tap on the eraser and tap it again, you have this option here called erase highlighter only. So if you toggle this on, this is really useful because you can erase only the highlighter without erasing the underlying handwriting. Whereas if you have this turned off, you will erase both the highlighter and your handwriting. Next, I'm going to show you how to use the lasso tool. So this is the lasso icon here, and if you tap on it, you can use the lasso tool to move objects around on the page. So let's say I wanted to move this object here. You can use the Apple Pencil and draw around it, and then tap inside and move it to where you want it to go. And once you're done, you can just let go and tap anywhere outside of the lasso area. And once again, you can draw around your objects, and you can also zoom out and then tap inside the lasso area, drag it to where you want it to go, and then tap outside. If you tap on the lasso icon again, you can see you have different options down here, and this is basically a selective lasso tool. So if I take off images and I just keep handwriting and text boxes on, this means I will move handwriting and text boxes, but not images. So let's try that out. So I'm just going to draw around this area, and you can see that I am moving the handwriting and then the text down here, but not the underlying images. And let's try it the other way. So I'm going to turn on images, but turn off handwriting and text. So I'm just moving the images without moving the handwriting and text. Next, I'm going to show you how you can change the color of handwriting, highlighters, shapes, and text. So you need to be on the lasso tool and then just lasso around all the objects you want to change the colors of. and then just tap inside the lasso area and then tap on color. And here you can change the color. So just select one of the presets or choose a custom color. And once you're done, you can just tap anywhere outside. You can also use the lasso tool to lasso around it, tap inside. You can copy and I can paste everything that I've just lassoed. You can also use the lasso tool to draw around everything, tap inside it, and then tap on resize. And this will allow you to resize whatever you've selected. And you can also rotate it. Next, I'm going to talk about the elements tool. So if you tap it once and then tap it again, it brings up this panel. And then you can scroll along the bottom to see their different sticker categories. There will be some that's already included with the app. And if you see a sticker that you want to use, you can just tap on it and that will add it to the page. You can also add your own items or a group of items into the elements tool. So to do that, just tap on the lasso tool and then draw around everything you want added as one item and then tap inside it and then tap on add element. And then you can just choose where you want it to go. So I'm just going to stick it under mind map shapes. And then when you go back into elements, under mind map shapes, you can see that this has added it to the end of the category. And I'm just going to go elsewhere on the page to demonstrate how that works. Let me go back in. And if I tap on this, that's going to insert both the handwriting and the image. Next, I'm going to show you how to use the image tool. So this picture icon here, if you tap on it, here are some images from your camera roll. And if you tap on the icon again, here is your camera roll larger, and you can just scroll through and pick an image. So I'm just going to choose this one. So just tap on it, and that's going to bring the image onto my page. And this is pretty large, so you can see this little circle at the bottom here. I'm just going to tap on it and hold, and you can then resize your image larger or smaller, and you can also rotate it. You can also tap on the image icon again and then tap insert from, and this will just give you more options to pick a file. So you can tap on browse and here you can choose cloud storage on my iPad, iCloud Drive, and you can browse the different places where your files are saved. So to edit an image that you already have on the page, you need to make sure that you have the picture icon tapped. So you need to just tap on the icon and then tap on your image. And you can see this image is now selected. So at this point, you can tap on this to delete the image, tap on this cross, or you can tap on this and resize it. You can also tap on the image and tap it again to bring up these options up here. And here you can tap on crop. And here you have two different options. You can have a rectangle crop where you can just change these handles on the side to crop it to how big or small you want it. So once you're done, just tap on done and you can see this is my cropped image. Or I'm just going to go back and then do that again. So tap it again, tap on crop. And this time I'm going to try freehand. So you can just draw around the shape you want to crop and then tap on done. You can also use the camera to take a photo. So here you have this camera icon, and if I tap on this, then you're prompted to take a photo, and my iPad's on the desk, so I'm just going to take a photo of my desk. And here you can just tap on use photo, and here is the image that you've just taken. Next, I'm going to talk about the text tool. So you can tap on this text icon here, and then you can choose your font from the font list and choose the size of your font. And here you can also choose the color of your font. And if you always use these selections, you can tap on this icon here and then tap on save as default. And this will just remember these settings that you picked. And then to use the text tool, you can just zoom into your page and then tap where you want to type. And then you can just use the keyboard to type your notes. And then you can just tap outside to come out of that text box. You can also edit the contents of a text box. So make sure that you're on the text icon and then just tap on the text box and then tap it twice again so that the content is completely selected. And then now you can change the color of the text. You can change the size of the text and you can also change your font. And here is a useful tip for the text tool. So if you put down a text box, you can write, and you see these blue dots on either side of the text box. If you just grab one of these, and it's a bit fiddly to do so, so sometimes it takes a couple of tries, you can actually drag this all the way out to where you want the text to stop. And this means that when you type, it will get to the end of this box and then it will naturally return, so it doesn't go past the width that you set. And this is really useful. Next, I'm going to show you how to use this zoom tool. So when you tap on this zoom tool, this will give you a magnified version of what's in this blue box up here. So you can move this blue box around, and you can also drag the blue corner here to minimize or to maximize your view down here. And you can place this over wherever you want to write. And you can also move this part down here as well using a finger. And I find this very useful because if you want more control over your handwriting, you should try writing larger. I find that helps you get more control. And the useful thing with this feature is that it will automatically prompt you to shift your view when you reach the end. So instead of reaching the end and then having to basically move it over manually with your finger, you can just write it here. And you can see this has automatically shifted the view for you. And to close this panel, you can just tap on the red cross here and you can get rid of that. Next, I'm going to show you how to add extra pages. So in view mode and in edit mode, you have this icon here. And if you tap it, it will prompt you to add a page. And you can choose to add it before, after your current page or to the last page of your file. And you can choose to duplicate your current page. So here you can see the current template, or you can choose to insert a blank page or like dotted. You can see these different options here. So I basically want another template like what I have at the moment. So I'm going to tap current template. And you can see this has basically duplicated the page that I was on minus the contents that was on the page. You can also manage your pages using the thumbnails view. So I'm just going to tap on this icon here with the four squares. And here you can see the thumbnails of all of your different pages. And here you can tap on select, tap on the page I want to copy. And then here you can tap copy. And then I want to paste this elsewhere. So first you have to tap on done. And then you have to browse to where you want to copy that page. So I want to copy it after this page. So then I'm going to tap on the arrow below it and I'm going to tap on add page after. And I'm going to paste the page. This is what I just copied. And this has basically duplicated that page and pasted it after this page here. And you can see the original page is still there. And you can also do this with a number of pages. It doesn't have to be one page. You can just select as many pages as you want and tap on copy. You can also move pages. And if you're only moving one page at a time, you can just long press on the page and drag it to where you want it to go. You can also delete pages whilst you're in thumbnails view. You can just tap on this arrow and tap move to trash. But be very careful deleting pages, because anything that's hyperlinked to this page, that hyperlink is going to break. So you don't want to do that unless you're very sure you do not need that hyperlink and you don't need this page. Next, I'm going to talk about the shapes tool. And if you tap on your shapes tool and go to where you want to draw your shape, and you can then choose the color and the stroke width, then all you have to do is just roughly draw the outline of your shape. And this doesn't have to be neat. But once you've closed the shape, you can just hold it and you can see that this is automatically snapped into a shape, and you can just let go and this has drawn a perfect shape for you. And you can draw other shapes as well. So just draw the shape and it will naturally snap into place. Next, I'm going to show you how to export your file so you can save and back it up. So I'm going to tap on this share icon here. And you can export just one page or export everything in that file. So I'm going to tap on export all. And here you have a couple of different options. So GoodNotes file is typically what I like to use because that retains all of the different editable elements. So you can still like erase the handwriting and you can use the lasso to move things around. But if you're sure that you do not want to edit anything, you just want a flattened PDF image that's not editable, you can pick the PDF option. And once you're done, you can rename it and then just tap on export. And this is going to prompt you to where you want to save it. So you can save it to your files or you can save it to cloud storage. It's up to you. So just tap the option and you can tap save. Next, I'm going to show you how to bookmark a page. So if there is a page that you use all the time and you want to be able to get to it quickly, you can add a bookmark. So this icon up here, if you tap it, it will turn red, meaning that this page is now bookmarked. So I'm just going to come out of this into my documents view. You can actually go to your favorites tab down here and you can see here are all of your bookmarked pages and you can just tap on it to access the bookmarked pages. And to remove a bookmark, you can just tap on the same icon to remove that bookmark. Next, I'm going to show you how to create a folder to organize your notes. So I'm just going to tap on the back button to go back into my documents view. And then you can tap on this new icon and then tap on folder. And then just give your folder a name. And you can see this folder has been created. And then to add files into that folder, you can just long press on it and then drag it in. Please give me a thumbs up if you found this video useful and check out my other GoodNotes videos. If you have any questions, just leave me a comment and subscribe to my channel for more GoodNotes videos, plan with me's, tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching.